Gene Merle Capers retired, the oldest active talk show host in America. My birthday is tomorrow. I will be 103 years old. See if you can make it. And I'm still turning it up and keeping it real on the Art McCoy radio show, the University of Common Sense. On WERE 1490. Anyone who takes offense at a day in your celebration, cause we all know in our minds that there are the
right, beautiful, that's a beautiful horn. We can do that.
But could it be more perfectly than to have a world party on the day you came to be? Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday to ya. Happy birthday. I just never understood how a man who died for good could not have a day that would. He said, aside for his recognition, because it can never be, just because some cannot see, the dream as clear as he. That day.
Judge, the final question that I want to ask you, Judge, is it important? How important is it for seniors to continue working and being active like yourself?
It's extraordinary because otherwise there wouldn't be anything to celebrate. And so the children have to realize that those like me are out there in the front. But we're only out there in the front because there were children like me that were standing on the shoulders of those that went before us, like Dr. Mary McLeod, that great educator that made the sacrifice for children that were denied the opportunity to go to school. But because we were denied the opportunity, we didn't stop there. And we just knew that there were some of us that were smarter than those that didn't believe that they should have an education and just got out there and made the education for them. And that's what we are known for.
Judge, did you know her?
Did I know her? I should say I did. And the National Council of Negro Women, that's why I was a part of it. Because there had been others that had gone before her on these shows. And my main ones were my mother's father. And I want all of you to join with me in the foundation that my sister, and other friends of all of us, a few of us that are left, are going to make the foundation. And I'm announcing that on this occasion of the property that they bought in 1930 at the height of the Depression, that you don't know anything about what they called the Depression. Why, just forget that. That's nothing. And we'll let you know more about it, but I'm announcing it today. And oh goodness, a beautiful flower arrangement.
All right, you just came in. Make your presentation because we're going to go on with the rest of the program. But make your presentation.
Heavy hitters, okay? So I'd like to introduce to all our listeners right now, we have Ms. Deborah Perkins from Faith Community United Credit Union, and also Mr. Larice Purnell from Faith Community United Credit Union, but also known as the founder of the Real Black Friday. How's everyone today?
First of all, we're a cooperative. We are members only. That makes us different from other financial institutions. We are in business to serve our members. We're also a not-for-profit, and that makes us different from other financial institutions. what we earn really belongs to our members. The products that we make available are for our members. The results that we achieve are for our members. So we're focused on our members. One member, one vote.
I just think that's beautiful because maybe again, talking about Faith Community United Credit Union, you cater to the disadvantaged. You cater to the population of the city and the Cuyahoga County that don't understand what membership may entail, what banking, or how to get involved with financial institutions.
That's exactly right. We are in business to serve the underserved. That's part of our mission. We are a community development credit union focused on those who really have no access to other more traditional financial institutions. And we do it in a way that allows them to improve their circumstances. They get their needs met, but at the same time, they position themselves for growth, for financial growth going forward.
I just love that. I just love it. Here's the problem I see in our community. You know, people literally, they don't understand the banking system. Mm-hmm. They say, well, no, I can't get a bank account because I only make minimum wage. Well, mm-hmm. How am I going to open a bank account? Is this a institution? I mean, how do you reach out to that person, that minimum wage worker?
We want that minimum wage worker. First of all, it takes $50 to become a member of Faith Community United.
$50?
That's it? $50.
Oh,
that's it. Come on over.
Okay.
And once you become a member, you have access to all of the services, all of the products, everything. You are entitled to everything that we do. If you're underage, if you're a youth, only $10 will open that account. If you're a business, because we do serve businesses as well, $100 will open that account for you. And again, that makes you a member and that gives you access to all of the loan products, all the deposit products, investments, everything.
Well, you know what? Let me tell you something I've been mad about for quite some time. I just want to know, Mr. Purnell, Ms. Perkins, how are we going to stop this payday loan, going up in people, these people get in this trap. How are we going to stop that? We're going to stop it in 2016, I hope. You know, we got to stop this vicious cycle. So what is some of Faith Community United Credit Union, what's some of your plan to stop this payday loan trap?
And you're right, it is indeed a trap. It's a vicious, vicious cycle. Payday loan rates, those alternative financial service providers, those payday loans, those pawn shops,
right.
The buy here, pay here, all of those alternative financial services providers are gouging our underserved, our underbanked, and our unbanked population. Mm-hmm. And certainly there are efforts in D.C. to bring that under control, but you know, the reality is these payday lenders are still thriving, and they are thriving in our communities. There are more than 800 payday lenders in the state of Ohio.
Wow.
Those are actual offices. One report says there are more payday loan outlets in the country than there are McDonald's. All of our products and services are available to you. And you're absolutely right. It's unfortunate and it's sad that our seniors have gotten caught up in that. So we need our seniors to come to us, take advantage of the financial advising and counseling that we provide, the coaching that we provide to help you get off that payday loan cycle. We can work with you, we'll meet you wherever you are, and we'll get you off that cycle. We'll get you putting money aside. You'll wake up 12 months from now and realize you don't need a payday loan or anything
like that.
How'd
they do that, Purnell?
Speak to that.
I'm going to jump in for Mr. Purnell.
Go ahead.
There are only 15 states in the country that restrict interest rates for payday loans. Ohio is one of those. The ceiling in Ohio is 28% for the traditional payday lender. But what they've done is reinvented themselves as title loan companies or as some special mortgage lender. They've come up with ways to circumvent the law. Now, the Consumer Finance Protection Bureau is on the case and is trying to, again,
put in place restrictions on those payday lenders. It seems to be an unending
when
cycle.
When I'm into the community, I've been a neutral guy. I'm kind of alone. I tell people I'm an introvert, you know, when I'm not speaking, you know, at different engagements or doing the jobs I have to do day to day. I'm a family man. You see me, I'm with my family here today.
Yes, and they're lovely.
Yes, I thank you so much. But what I've done is I've went out in the community and I tell people, you, these organizations that are here, they're waiting for the people to come to them. I'm doing it like ministry, kind of like you, I'm Brother McCoy. I'm taking it to the streets, business in a box. I'm going to the businesses. I just spent yesterday with my family, and we hit about 20 businesses. I went in just shaking hands, asking questions. What are some of your barriers that are facing you that's not allowing you to grow? And I think doing that over probably 2 or 3 months, I was able to build relationships. And that's what with this social media, this technology now, we're not building relationships. We're not getting in front of each other. We're not talking to one another. So through that, as well as, you know, breaking the clicks. When you see the billboards I put up, Brother McCoy, right, you see it's different people that you wouldn't usually see together. Mm-hmm. I'm bringing them together and showing them that the only way we're going to do this, you got to come out your comfort zone and work as one unit so we can build this community. You can't be over here buying this. You can't be over here buying from ABC company. You buy from EZ company. You got to do it all together so then we can grow economically as one unit, and then there's no break or barriers within each other. So that's important now. So
right.
So all that being said is, and I'm going to continue to do that. If you look at the panel I have this weekend coming, those are people that you would not see in the room working together. We all support one another, but you wouldn't see them, you know, support one another on a daily basis. So that's what I feel like God has given me to say, bring them together, be honest with them, be transparent, talk about the agendas on the table when we're sitting in front of each other. And I think that's where the success has come from. My transparency, my love, they see the commitment. And like you said, money doesn't sleep. When they're asleep at night, at 3:00 in the morning, my wife would tell you, I'm sending emails, I'm writing proposals and putting things together that's going to truly impact this community. It's not about me. It's about who's going to be impacted by what God has given me.
Right,
so.
And he's talking about, you know what, I totally agree with you, Mr. Purnell. And as you talk about a community, you got these different cliques. You can call them factions. You can call them whatever you want to call it. And I'm going to put you on the spot, Mr. McCoy, because you're in one. You're one of them cliques of the successful black barbers and barbershops or hairdressers. I'm sorry to tell you, but you are. Okay? So, and what he's saying is, here we are supporting each other. If we had got all those black barbershops and all those black beauty shops and supported a credit union together in a community, then we could have got more businesses
perhaps
open.
East Cleveland
wouldn't look like a ghost town with every business closed down. So, you know, it starts with the community.
Meetings on multiple occasions. We're talking about, we are here to change. She was brought on board. I'm the board chairman. She's the CEO. We're here to change. That's the only way we're going to change this community. If we don't focus on our economics, you can't have real change. You can talk, but if you don't have money, money is power. That's how you're going to change schools. That's how you're going to start to own this community. That's how you're going to create jobs. So this is going to be the foundation. We need people to come out, support, put their money in a bank, in an institute, a credit union that's willing to support the community.
Right.
It's a cycle. We talk about the cycle, keeping the dollar cycle.
Right.
I tell people, don't talk about the 6 hours the dollar stays in the community.
Right.
Let's talk about the new cycle. So what are we creating going forward?
Mm-hmm.
So faith is going to be transformation to help the transformation in this community.
Right.
So we can say, now, you know what? It stays in the community 6 hours.
Right.
Because through faith, you come get your business loan. Through faith, you come get your home loan. Through faith, you come get your car loan. And we're going to make sure we put you in position so you don't have to go to the title loan places.
Right. Right.
To the payday loan. So.
But you know what I like too? You know, something that Ms. Perkins said is, it's not just that, but you have financial advisors and coaches to help you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we got people out here with bank accounts and all they do is deposit their check, walk away, and they never get any coaching. They don't even understand what the power is of their deposit.
Mm-hmm.
They don't understand what the bank is using their deposit for.
Mm-hmm.
So I like to hear that, where you're actually talking about coaching people, let you understand what your deposit and your membership in the credit union is going to
do
for you, but more importantly, your community.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes, you know, we have some people, they want to help, and then, you know what? Well, I don't know, I just work it. But when you're working,
when you getting your paycheck, instead of you going and putting it and get it cash, the check cash in place, then if you go in and support Faith Community United Credit Union, this organization.
Mm-hmm. All right, she's going to answer.
Thank you for your call, brother.
Absolutely. Thank you for that comment. And we are extremely active in the community. A couple of things. First of all, if you look around the community, you won't find any other financial institutions anyway. You'll find us. There are no other traditional financial institutions serving the neighborhood. So first of all, we're accessible. That's giving back. What kinds of things have we done? We've had programs at various schools where we have talked to those students about saving and the importance of financial independence. We provided uniforms for the League Park Chargers in Huff this summer. 7-year-olds who needed football jerseys. We got those football jerseys for them, and they were excited. You wouldn't believe how excited they were. Community Day. Community Day comes once a year for Faith Community United Credit Union. We have food and games and prizes for anyone in the community who comes to our institution. We talk about what we do, and we show them who we are. No one else reaches out like that to our community, but we do. Career Day, we're going and we're talking and representing our credit union at various schools. There's a Mad City competition now for scholarships for colleges, for juniors and seniors. We're part of that. So we are active in the community, demonstrating the value of having a credit union in the community.
Right, and what a wonderful value at Faith Community United Credit Union. For those that don't know, they're located at 3550 East 93rd Street in Cleveland. And if you'd like to, you can always give them a call at 271-7111. And those that are able can look them up at www.faith.com.
The first question is, biggest question I'm going to ask you. No, if you go to Facebook, is will you leave bills or benefits? That's the big question I'm asking this entire community, everybody listening, and I'll be asking it that day. And that's when you talk about the direct correlation with Faith Community, Credit Union.
Yes.
We're going to be building the economic platform of this community. So you have people like Philly Whedon that everybody knows. I'm from Naturally Gifted. He's been, you know, a businessman for some years. You have Bashir Jones. You have Maggie Anderson coming from Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
And you also have Paul Sadler. Junior, that'll be on the panel, and Danita Harris will be the moderator, and Sam Silk, your very own, will be the MC of the event. And I'll be on the panel as well, just talking about the great things that we're doing and how we are going to link the community. Before we leave that room, I'm going to have about 2,000 people wrap their arms together to talk about the success. If we work together,
mm-hmm.
what the power of that will be. I'll have superintendents that have confirmed. I have mayors that have confirmed. I have doctors that have confirmed. I have educators that have confirmed. Psychologists that have confirmed.
Okay.
Bankers. So all that being said, we're inviting about 500 kids because I needed them to see that does exist.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need to go to social media and find just the rappers or the people that, you know, that are glorified. We also have people, you can be a professional and be glorified as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just going to be a day of education. We have about 130 black-owned businesses that will be in the building, that we can bring awareness. That's one of the key things. If I ask most people I'm in the room with, name 5 black businesses besides the person who does your hair and a restaurant.
Mm.
In most rooms, people can't answer that.
Yeah.
So all that being said, I feel like God has given me this vision to bring awareness to these black businesses. And Faith will be right there by my side. We will be opening accounts, really helping
Oh,
absolutely.
We have to get back to that. But we have to remember to invest in ourselves first. And we have to get away from being consumers of all of our resources. Put some things away. That's part of what we're talking about when we talk about financial empowerment. Save for your own retirement. Save for the next generation. I remember hearing someone say, well, I can't take it with me, so I might as well spend it while I'm here. No, leave it. Grow our community. Leave it for that next generation. That's how we leverage, and that's how we grow, and that's how we keep going.
Absolutely.
Go ahead, brother. I would like to say, I want to make sure you understand when you ask me about where have the businesses gone. Faith Community United Credit Union has been around for 64 years. So when I ask the question, do you know the businesses that exist, that's a gem that's right here in our community that when we talk about legacy and just generational transfer of wealth, we have to
know that.
This is the first African-American female mayor of the city of Maple Heights.
All right.
Well, I'm so honored to be sitting next to her today.
This is the Honorable Mayor Blackwell sitting here with us in
so,
the studio.
So hold on a minute.
What?
Sister, didn't this show play a crucial part?
You said mayor.
Didn't this show play a crucial part in getting you elected? Talk to me.
Yes, it did. All right.
Thank you
so much, Mayor Blackwell. We were absolutely thrilled as we watched your campaign.
Thank you.
A little concerned at first on pins and needles at first. But do you know, I can't tell you the joy and honor that we have and just having met you before. And then thank you so much for coming to our studio,
Absolutely. Especially
on this special day as we honor Judge Capers and her 103rd birthday.
Happy birthday.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. Things are going to change.
Absolutely.
Since you are out there.
Absolutely.
Things don't change in Maple Heights. Well, let me just tell you this. I know you got a lot on your plate, okay? You're not starting from scratch, so to speak.
Oh, yes, I am.
Tell us about it. Tell us about the starting from scratch at Maple Heights. What was the...
To build something up, you first got to tear it down.
Okay. All right. Yeah. And you got to tear down all of those old issues that were going on in the city. All
allegiances. Dysfunction.
Okay, dysfunction.
Curses, whatever you want to call it.
Right. You know what? Financially for the city, okay? How is this going to affect you coming in as mayor? With that
every single day, I've got one focus.
Okay.
And that's to get out of fiscal emergency.
Okay.
When you walk into, when you hear the word fiscal emergency, emergency means ambulance, red light, 911.
Right.
It's immediate, the need. And so with emergency being a part of the issue in Maple Heights, that is my number one priority all day, every day.
Mm-hmm.
And doesn't stop when I leave the office. I've been in the office 5 days, and every day I've been there to about 9. I think Friday I left at 10 o'clock.
Okay, so you got to pace yourself, okay? Don't let them burn you out already with all of these issues.
Oh, that's right.
But you know what? It's just like one of the first things you said when we talked before you were mayor. You said, we've got to get some business and some opportunities growing in the city of Maple Heights.
Absolutely.
You know?
It sounds like we need a branch of Faith Community Credit Union.
Exactly.
In Maple Heights. I'm just saying.
I would love to have that meeting.
Accessible off of the freeway.
Right.
Hey, just to be...
We're a great location.
Right.
We don't have a credit union.
Would love to have that conversation because the majority,
tend to give lower credit interest rates.
Absolutely.
And for people who don't have, great credit scores, as a caller before, and the payday loans, which are, areas like Maple Heights and other areas, really benefit from just getting them helping with just a basic checking account, how to manage credit and how to manage their paycheck. So I would really love a credit union.
And about 40% of our members actually live in your city.
Okay, great.
Okay, you know what? I love it when, people get together and you know how you get those goosebumps with those ideas and everything's growing. But you know what, Mayor Blackwell, what's important too is, like I said, I don't want you to
work.
I'm not working too hard, and always get your rest. And remember, now that you assume this role, the city is gonna go on, but we need you to be strong too.
Thank you. You know what I'm saying? Thank you.
So you always remember to take care of yourself and your family, and keep God first. You know that.
Yes.
But I know already when you're telling me you work until 10 o'clock at night, you tell them people you got to go.
Well, you know what? 10 o'clock, I'm come from a tax background. I've been at the firm, it's been my busy season.
Oh, okay.
So I have been conditioned for 16 years working in the accounting tax background. Mm-hmm. Busy season means it is a 60, 70 hour week.
Wow.
So I am used to that. But really what I try to do is to give the city, and right now I'm trying to learn all of my staff, directors, police, fire, those individuals personally. And they're in my office, up to 5 o'clock. So from about 5 to 10 is when I do what I do very quietly.
Okay.
But that's not gonna keep up. But, I came in just really anxious to be ready day one. It's important if you take on an undertaking such as this, you're ready day one. And so although I took office, I walked in the office January 4th, I had begun to work many weeks before. I just to get in the office to begin to implement those things. Okay. So I was excited. Mm-hmm. And I had this agenda, and I keep this running kind of task list in my head. I need to get through the task list.
Okay.
But I promise you, as I have some of those things
open
done.
Again, get the basketball hoops back up. Continue to get Southgate with the shopping that's desirable, that's convenient. The stores that you want to see. We have Foreman Mills, which right now is in Cleveland opening up. We have Honeybaked Ham that's moved from across the street over to Southgate. I actually have a meeting on Tuesday with Southgate. So I think the residents need to tell them what we want in terms of shopping. We just don't want a bunch of dollar stores, and I have nothing against dollar stores, mm-hmm. but some of us have a budget that's a little bit bigger than a dollar store, so that we have shopping that reaches all budgets, dollar and more high-end if that's what we choose, so we don't have to leave us communities to do that kind of retail shopping. And as well, and they create some local jobs. Or at least we're in a position, if we can get you in the right housing, to get you to jobs beyond Maple Heights because of our access, our location and our easy access and quick access to highways. Unlike some other communities, which I won't name, you have to drive 20 minutes to a highway.
Ms. Controversy, I'm running real late on time. Judge.
Yes.
Speak right in that microphone. Judge, have the last word. They've showed you so much love.
Yeah.
How are you going to reciprocate in 1 minute and show that love right back? Give me my 50 cent, man. She can't pump her up. She loves
her. Talk over that. Let her talk. Go on, baby.
Well, I am just really, for the first time in my life, if I'm admitting it, you know that it's true. But I've always told the truth. So I'm breathless, and so I just don't know what to say. Because I didn't know anything about any of this, and I've learned so much, really, and had made up my mind that the time had come that I had run out of energy, especially when they took away my feet, because it was my good walking feet and legs that really brought me to all of you, and I miss all of you, but I'm looking around my young ladies, and I see that Cleveland doesn't have anything to worry about, from the best radio show promoter to the newest mayor that we do have. Although, you know, the men were my specialty, though, see. But my ladies, I'm just kind of partial to them, you see.
Judge, we got to go.
All right, I want to thank all of you from the bottom of my heart. But I'll be around for a long time.
Oh, ain't no doubt about it.
All right.
All right. Listen, on behalf of...